Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about wattar meter type of induction relay. So in this relay there are two electromagnets, upper electromagnet and lower electromagnet, but both the electromagnets are excited from the single source. So let us study in detail the wattar meter type of induction relay. The diagram of the wattar meter type of induction relay is as shown in figure. So here there are two electromagnets, upper electromagnet and lower electromagnet. Then both the electromagnet consist of the coils. If we see carefully, the relay coil of the upper electromagnet is energized from the current. Then the secondary coil of upper electromagnet is connected to the lower electromagnet. Then there is one disc which is free to rotate between the two electromagnets, and these are the contacts to the trip circuit. This disc is made up of aluminium. So now let us study what is the working principle of this type of relay. So this type of relay has a double winding structure. It consists of two magnets. First is E-shaped magnet, which is the upper magnet. Second is U-shaped magnet, which is the lower magnet. Same can be seen in the figure. So if we see, this is the upper magnet and its shape is of letter E. Hence it is called as E-shaped magnet. Then this is our lower electromagnet and its shape is that of letter U. Hence it is called as U-shaped magnet. The disc is present between the two electromagnets, which is free to rotate. The upper E-shaped magnet carries the primary winding, which is the relay coil, and the secondary winding. The primary winding carries the relay current I1. Now this current will produce its own flux, that is phi1. Now, as there is a flux, so there is a magnetic field. So the coil will now act as a conductor placed in the magnetic field. We know that as per the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, when the conductor is placed in the magnetic field, then EMF is induced. So EMF gets induced in the secondary winding due to this flux. Flux is produced in the primary winding. This flux will link with the secondary winding. Let us see this from the diagram. So this is our primary winding. Current I1 is flowing through the primary winding. As the current I1 is flowing through the primary winding, it will produce the flux phi1. This flux will link with the secondary winding. As a result, EMF gets induced in this secondary winding. This induced EMF will drive the current I2 in the secondary winding. Due to this current I2, it will produce its own flux phi2. Now this flux phi2 will get induced in the lower magnet. Let us see this from the figure. Now if we see the figure, due to the flux phi1, EMF gets induced. Due to this EMF, current I2 will start to flow. Now due to this current I2, it will produce its own flux, that is phi2. This flux phi2 will link with the lower magnet. Now this flux phi2 will lag the main flux phi1 by an angle of alpha. Due to the interaction of these two fluxes, the torque is exerted on the disc and the disc will rotate. Assuming that entire flux phi1 enters the disc from the upper magnet and entire flux phi2 will enter the disc from the lower magnet, we can write the equation of the torque as torque is directly proportional to phi1 phi2 sine of alpha, where alpha is the angle between the two fluxes phi1 and phi2. So let us summarize this relay. So there are two electromagnets, upper electromagnet which is in E-shaped and lower electromagnet which is in U-shaped. Now, upper electromagnet consists of two windings, primary winding and secondary winding. The secondary winding of the upper electromagnet is connected to the lower electromagnet. Now, the upper electromagnet primary winding will get energized due to the current. As a result of this, the magnetic field is produced and the flux phi 1 will get linked with the secondary winding. Due to this, the EMF is induced in the secondary winding. Because of this EMF, current I2 will start to flow in the secondary winding, and via secondary winding, as it is connected to the lower electromagnet, this current will flow in the lower electromagnet. Now, this current will produce its own flux, that is phi 2. The phase difference between the two fluxes is angle alpha. Due to the interaction of these two fluxes, torque will be produced, whose formula is given by torque is directly proportional to phi 1 phi 2 sine of alpha, and because of this torque, disc will rotate. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and do subscribe our channel Ikeda. Thank you.